nation, of a group of people, struggle a lot with their identity, right? So this story that you saw definitely gives great identity frameworks. Okay? It's great to relate to a nation that had so many successes in their past. At the same time, it's obviously a kind of propaganda tool that is constructed in order to support a very strict dominant view over the history. We are the descendants of heroes. In all that, the recent debate about what is called, as a shortcut, the Holocaust Law, also shows us a very interesting thing, a Polish context, okay? A context of history where you see that we as a nation are not ready, probably, to see ourselves as a diversified, you know, domain of people. What is really very important to look at is that the narrative that was created is quite non-problematic, okay? Now, there are some things that we would like to be discussing right now, and in a minute, and one of them is, how is it possible to handle a very difficult challenge of facing the diverse past, okay? We saw a good part of Poland's history, something that we should be proud of. It was narrated in a very nice, epic style, but as you saw, nothing was mentioned about not the perfect part of Poles. Some people say that Poles want to see themselves as another chosen nation. Maybe that explains basically some of our problems, but What I would like to ask you is whether you know, as young people, also not knowing Poland very well maybe, do you see any way of confronting the past which is actually diverse? And do you see any way of actually trying to face the debate, face the past which is not that good, in a way that we don't actually lose the very important identity frameworks that we need as Poles? So, to sum up, I've used several concepts that I wanted to relate to the recent crisis about the commemoration of the Holocaust. One of them was that we're not really talking about history. We are talking about social memory, remembrance, and heritage view. Okay? Their main social function is to provide us, with relevant, strong identity framework so that Poles know who they are. Okay? The second thing is that in the narratives about the past, we have to use some collective formatives, some collective figures, such as nation, because it is virtually impossible to tell every single story of every single person that was in the past. That obviously, history or the past narrated in that way is very vulnerable for any manipulations and abuses, okay? So, one of the challenges would be to tell honestly the story of Poland or any nation, with the use of big quantitatives such as the nation, the church, some other institutions, okay? But also highlighting the input of individuals. So I talked about identity, legitimacy, about the narratives of diversified and diverse past. And finally,